Xenon lamps generate an extremely high level of heat. Most of the heat needs to be removed from the lamp and projector in a rapid and efficient manner. Trapped heat and excessive temperatures must be avoided in order to protect both the projector and the lamp. If the upper limit of 230 degrees Celsius is exceeded, the lamp base and cable start to discolor from light yellow to brown and dark blue in extreme cases. It can also lead to secondary failures. Lamp darkening will start to occur at an accelerated rate, and in severe cases, the oxidation protection that seals the xenon gas inside the lamp can be burned away, creating an air leak, and ruin the lamp. Please refer to the respective projector manual for all installation, service, and maintenance-related activities. Are the projector exhaust and extraction fans running and moving air at the correct volumes and speeds needed to cool the lamp specified by the projector manufacturer? If the roof extraction fan is off, the projector's ability to cool itself and the lamp will be greatly diminished. If left untended, this can lead to projector error, which will shut the lamp off to protect the electronics. To check the extraction, remove the ducting from the projector exhaust and place your hand just inside the opening. If you feel your hand being pulled into the hole, the roof extraction is on and functional. Next, we need to see if the extraction is moving the hot air at the correct volumes and speeds to cool the lamp. The use of an anemometer is needed in order to take these measurements. Each projector brand and model will have different specifications, and the appropriate installation or service manual should be used to find the correct range. Are all the projector filters clean, and is the extraction system functioning at the needed levels? OSRAM has proven that dirty filters increase the temperature of the lamp. The data collected is displayed on this graph. On the x-axis, we are tracking time, and on the y-axis, we will be tracking temperature. Pay attention to the temperature spike when a clean filter is exchanged for a dirty one, and the drop when a clean filter is used again. Barco projectors have three filters that need periodic cleaning. To access the filters, the left side cover and the input cover will need to be removed. Here is the card cage filter. Here is the heat exchange filter. And here is the igniter SPG filter. The dirtier the environment, the more frequently they need to be cleaned. They should be cleaned a minimum of once a month, as described in the Barco user manual. Loose screws and connections in the lamp area will increase the resistance in the circuit and cause higher than desired lamp temperatures. Check all lamp connections to make sure they are tight. Protective equipment should be worn while working with cinema lamps. Failure to do so can result in damage to yourself and the projector. For Barco lamp houses, ensure that the cathode adapter sits flush with the lamp's base. Make sure that the 5mm Allen screw connecting the lamp to the lamp house is correctly tightened. Confirm that the anode side of the lamp is safely supported in the lamp house. Establish that the lamp lead cable has been secured. And finally, that the igniter terminal insulators are properly oriented. Is the lamp being operated with the correct operational parameters? You will need to refer to the service card inside the lamp box or online for this information. Barco and Christie operators can use the information as a reference while viewing the current and wattage readings from the projector software. Is the lamp correctly aligned within the projector's optical system? Correctly aligning the lamp within the reflector has a major impact on how much light the projector is able to produce on screen. What you're actually doing when you're performing an alignment is positioning the tip of the cathode lamp electrode in the focal point of the reflector. 80 to 90% of all the light being produced by the lamp is being generated at this tip, so precise positioning is needed to achieve optimal alignment and light output. It is important to also note that as the lamp ages, the cathode tip will start to erode away and flatten over time, shifting the hotspot on the cathode tip out of the reflector's focal point, decreasing the maximum light output of the projector. To remedy this situation, a realignment is performed and the aged cathode tip is moved back into alignment with the reflector's focal point. If a lamp is far enough out of alignment, there may be thermal damage to the lamp base and cable, which will negatively affect performance. Lamp alignment should be performed at least 2 times throughout a lamp's life, which will maximize the light output of the projector each time it is done, while causing no damage to the lamp. When performing an alignment, the lamp should be set to maximum power and allowed to warm up and stabilize for a minimum of 10 minutes prior to starting the procedure. Where possible, have the projector display a white test pattern on screen, allowing you to inspect the screen for light uniformity during the alignment process.